I'm going to do a short interview with Poland's very own Professor Kundzewicz, and please welcome him up as he sits. The aim is just to have an informal conversation with one of Poland's leading researchers, his thoughts on climate change, his thoughts on communicating science and starting a movement. But if you do not know who he is, can you please introduce yourself?
Okay, my name is Zbigniew Kundzewicz. I'm working in two institutions in two countries, actually. So my principal work is the Polish Academy of Sciences in Poznań, but I'm also working part-time in Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research in Potsdam, Germany.
There is a recent report, let's start with that, the IPCC report this year. My newspaper and lots of others have written a lot about it. Can you tell us what was in that report and what your role is with that?
Right, I have been active in IPCC for about 20 years now. Four times I have been a coordinating lead author. The Working Group 1 report, well, was issued in September, and it was quite an important message that this report was carrying.
What was that message?
Namely that it is extremely likely that most of the warming is of anthropogenic origin. Most of the warming within the last 50 years. Extremely likely means that probability is higher than 95%.
Okay, so it means that 95%
at least
95%. I thought it was really interesting so far to hear you talk compared to, for example, how Rachel Kite was talking. She said we could not say that Typhoon Haiyan was a result of climate change, but if we looked at a lot of the impacts, then we could conclude that the intensity of it was to do with climate change. And you're talking about things being extremely likely. And I just thought, is there a dichotomy between how policymakers and activists and NGOs want to frame climate change and how scientists frame it?
You know, IPCC is about the interaction of science and policy, because scientists deliver their stories, deliver their results, and policymakers want a simplified view. So it is for them that the categories of likelihood were invented. So they are discrete categories. Like likely means at least 66%, very likely at least 90, extremely likely 95. And virtually certain, next category would be 99%.
What does extremely likely mean for the people sat here today? How should that change how people think and act?
Well, it all depends on the risk. For instance, If they tell you, it is extremely likely that this flight will succeed, that this plane will not fall, and it means 95% who says, no, I don't fly. So it all depends on a risk, on a hazard. Actually, this number or this statement is quite conservative. Personally, I have been dealing with this problem for many years. I have seen no other explanation of the warming. Without anthropogenic change, without anthropogenic emission of greenhouse gases, we cannot explain the warming. The sun is there. It is perhaps responsible for 10% of change, but not for more. So majority of increase is indeed due to humans. And so I, even being a scientist, I would be less conservative. So my number would be even higher than 95.
You know, you were saying that the science tells us one thing, but if we look, and you were showing me some screen grabs of the Polish press, why is it so difficult to get people to accept that? And, you know, maybe we should talk about your experience. We've talked about your work as a researcher. As someone from Poland, when you look at your own media and the messages that come out about climate change or not, why do you think that there is such a divide between what you know and what people are told?
Paul Simon wrote, "A man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest." In Poland, the inconvenient truth is very inconvenient because we sit on coal. Well, for a long time, over 90% of electricity was produced from coal or peat burning. Poland is a country of many skeptics. And also, mainstream journalists choose sometimes a very attractive theme for a cover story, like the climate is cooling. Well, we should try first to answer four easy questions. Is the climate warming? Yes, no question about that. Is warming good or bad? Depends. but large warming will be better, will be bad for the globe. Then is it caused by MM? And then can we do anything about it? Unfortunately, Polish society, and not only Polish, other societies are divided as to these four questions. The scientists, they have a very difficult role to play because we sit between a hammer and an anvil. Our truth is unwanted. If somebody says global climate warming is a hoax, the media jump on him or her. He's a star. So he's invited and he delivers this false message to the nation, unfortunately. And some of those have scientific titles. They are professors. Mm-hmm. But they are talking irresponsible things. They are talking untruths.
Wow. Okay. A lot of effort is spent on that, trying to tell people that climate change is happening, but not very much on trying to give the people who know and accept that climate change is happening, a lot like people in this room, a sense of what they can do. So what is the advice from a scientist?
I would say, well, I listened very carefully to the morning session. One man can make a difference. So the fate of a climate is in our hands. We can do a lot by changing our habits, by doing things that make sense anyway. It's always good to save energy. It's always good to save water. So don't look for megawatts, look for negawatts, negative watts. Yeah? So saved energy is better than new production. Of course, we cannot solve our energy problems this way, but we can go a long way, improving our habits, improving our insulation of our houses, buildings, cars, being more efficient. So I think every one of us has a role to play.
Okay.
Especially the youth.
Okay, well, over to those youth now. Does anybody have any questions for Professor Kundzewicz?
I would like to know what is the biggest obstacle in researching the climate change. Is it maybe the skepticism, or is it maybe conflicts of interest between countries and politicians?
Well, you ask about the biggest obstacle in researching climate change. So if you pose a question this way, then neither skepticism nor conflicts of interest is an answer. Scientists are doing their best. The problem is very difficult because you have to disentangle natural variability of climate and anthropogenic component. It's extremely difficult. The climate is a complex system.
As you said, the Polish economy is highly dependent on coal. So my question would be, is it possible at the time being to somewhat politically, economically, physically change this the way it is and somehow switch from the fossil fuels to other sources of energy? And if so, how long could it take?
Yeah, thank you. It's a very important question. It's a big issue in our country, in Poland. Things are getting better. We are going in this way, but maybe not fast enough. 20 years ago, 96% of our electricity was produced of coal and peat. Now 86, so 10% improvement in 20 years. 20 difficult years, because they were years of a transition of the economy. Unfortunately, in Poland, we do not have much sun, as you may have seen outside. So solar energy, yeah, it's important, but it will not solve our problems. We do not have much wind, which is quite good, because wind sometimes can be dangerous. So we have wind farms, but not many. The renewable that we can use is biomass. And also there is a hope in shale gas. Nobody knows how much shale gas do we have, but apparently quite a lot. So there is still to be explored. And carbon footprint of shale gas is lower than the coal.
That might lead to other problems with fracking, wouldn't it?
There are other problems involved.
Cross that bridge when you get to it. And for our final question.
Jaki wpływ będzie miała ta zmiana w Polsce? Zmniejszenie naszej ilości w porównaniu do innych krajów, kiedy nasza produkcja jest dość mała.
Poland is responsible for 1% of global emission. So it's not a big player yet. I think it's also important that Poland improves efficiency and reduces the emissions in line with the European Union. If we improve 1%, we will not save the global climate, that's for sure, yeah. Because China produces 40 times more, or 45. US is the second producer. But I think we can make a difference, not only symbolic, if other countries follow.
Great. Can I have a round of applause, please, for Professor Kundzewicz, and thank you for all your questions.